Hello students, so in this video lesson we are going to solve some numericals of the chapter physical quantities and measurement. This is the second chapter which I have already started, and in my previous video I have explained this chapter, so you go through that video once more if you have not understood the chapter and try to solve some numericals from your book. Okay, also the questions which I am going to do it in board, that one also you need to copy in your exercise book. Okay, so let's start our video lesson today. So the first question we have, question number one, the density of sand is 1500 kg per meter cube. What is the mass? Point number A, 1 meter cube of sand, and point number B, 10 meter cube of sand. Right? So this is the question. The density of sand is 1500 kg per meter cube. So density we know, mass by volume. So how much is the mass? That is 1500, and volume means 1 meter cube. This is kg. So that's why we say kg per meter cube. The density is given here, 1500 kg per meter cube. So 1 meter cube, in 1 meter cube, what is the mass? So mass of 1 meter cube equals to 1500 kg. Similarly, this is point number 1 answer. And point number B answer, mass of 10 meter cube, that is multiply by 10, that is 15,000 kg. Okay, so this is the answer. So 1 meter cube mass is 1500, and 10 meter cube mass will be 10 into 1500, that is 15,000. Next question we have in the board, what is the density of milk in 1 milliliter? Of milk has a mass of 1.03 gram. So volume is 1 milliliter. This can be written as 1 centimeter cube. Okay, 1 milliliter equals to 1 centimeter cube. And mass we have 1.03 gram. Okay, what we need to find? Density. That means density equals to question mark. We know density equals to mass by volume. So mass is how much? 1.03, and volume is what? 1 centimeter cube. This is gram, so 1.03 gram per centimeter cube is the answer. Okay, so you can write there 1.03 gram per milliliter also, because 1 milliliter equals to 1 centimeter cube. So now we have to compare the densities of two objects. Okay, so next question we have, which will occupy more space? That means which will have more volume? We have to calculate volume. 720 gram of mahogany will of density this much, or 2710 gram of marble whose density is this much, right? So we have two objects, one is wood and one is marble. So we have to calculate whether they are going to occupy same volume or not. Okay, so first we will be calculating volume of wood separately and volume of marble separately, and we will compare those volume. Okay, so for mahogany wood, let us consider this portion, and for marble. And for wood, what we have given? Mass is given here, 720 gram, and density is given 0.72 gram per centimeter cube, right? Similarly, for marble, mass is given 2710 gram, and density is given here, 2.71 gram per centimeter cube. We know density equals to mass by volume. Or volume can be written as mass by density. So what is the mass here? 2710, and density we have 2.71. So if this point will remove, then two zeros will be going off, because after two digit point is there. That means 271. 271, 10s are 2710, so 10 into 100, that is 1000. 1000 centimeter cube, right? This is the volume. Here also we will calculate the volume. So volume equals to mass by density. So how much is the mass? 720, and volume is 720. So 720 into 1, 2, 3. After 3-digit point is there. So 3 zeros will be going up and 720 down. So 720 and 720 cancel. So how much do we get here? 1000 centimeter cube. You see, volumes are same. So they will occupy same space. Okay, so this is the answer. Both will occupy same space. Okay, so what was the question? Which will occupy more space? Both will occupy same space because volume is same. Question number 4, we have the volume of 60 gram of substance is 20 centimeter cube. That means mass here it is given 60 gram and volume is given 20 centimeter cube. This object, if the density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube, will the substance sink or float in water? So what is the question here? So we have water and we need to calculate the density of this substance whose mass and volume is given. So after calculation of that density, we have to compare with the density of water. If it is more than 1 gram per centimeter cube, then definitely it will sink inside. We know if the density of any object is heavier than the density of liquid, then it will sink inside. If the density of an object is less than the density of a given fluid or liquid, then it will float out. Okay, so first we will calculate the density. So density equals to mass by volume. So mass is given as 60 and volume is given 20. So 20 into 3, that is 3 gram per centimeter cube. So the density of object is 3 gram per centimeter cube, but density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube. So here density of a substance is greater than density of water, so it will sink. This is the answer, right? So what is the density here? 3 gram per centimeter cube, and the density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube. As this is greater than this, so it will sink inside. Okay, so this is the answer. Next question we have, find the volume of 900 gram of cooking oil whose density is 0.9 per gram per centimeter cube. So first we will note down here, mass is given 900 gram, density is given 0.9 gram per centimeter cube. So first we will calculate volume. Okay, so volume equals to mass by density. This is the formula. Okay, so we know density equals to mass by volume, but when we will calculate volume, so volume will go here, density will come here. So volume will be mass by density, right? So that formula we are using here. So volume equals to mass. So how much is the mass? 900 gram, and density is 0.9. So this point is after one digit, so one zero will be going up and point will get vanish. So 900, so 100 into 10, that is 1000 centimeter cube. Okay, this 1000 centimeter cube can be written as 1000 milliliter, because 1 milliliter equals to 1 centimeter cube. Again, we need to calculate answer in liter. So 1000 milliliter equals to 1 liter. So this is the answer. Okay, so at last we have to convert centimeter cube to milliliter and milliliter to liter. Next question we have, what is the mass of air in a room measuring 10 meter into 5.2 meter into 2.5 meter? That means length is given, breadth is given, and height is given. So this is the dimension of that room. Okay, if the density of air is 1.3 kg per meter cube, so dimension is how much space it is occupying. That means this is the volume. Volume equals to 10 into 5.2 into 2.5. If we calculate this one, 10 into 52 by 10 into 25 by 10, 1010 got cancelled. Now 52 into 25, we will multiply this one. That is 1300. Okay, divided by 10. So 00 got cancelled, that is 130 centimeter cube or meter cube here. Unit is given in terms of meter cube, right? Now if the density is 1.3 kg पर मीटर क्यूब, व्हाट वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट मास। सो डेंसिटी इक्वल्स टू मास बाय वॉल्यूम, सो मास इक्वल्स टू डेंसिटी इनटू वॉल्यूम। सो हाउ मच इज द डेंसिटी 1.3 एंड वॉल्यूम वी हैव 130, राइट। सो 13 बाय 10 इनटू 130, 0 एंड 0 गॉट कैंसिल, सो 13 इनटू 13 169 kg। सो दिस इज द आंसर। Okay, so first what we have done here, first we have calculated the volume. We have multiplied each and every term. After multiplication, we got the answer in kg per meter cube. And we need to calculate here mass. So mass equals to density into volume. So substitute the value of density and volume. Multiply, then you will get the answer. Okay, so answer is 169 kg. That is the mass of an air in that room. So next question, we have an empty density bottle weighs 30 gram and 54 gram when filled with kerosene. So there is one container. The weight of that container when it is not filled with kerosene is 30 gram. But when you fill with kerosene, the weight of that bottle became 54 gram. If the volume of the bottle is 30 milliliter, find the density of kerosene in gram per centimeter cube, in kg per meter cube and relative density. Okay, so this thing, three things we have to find. So first we note down what is given in the question. An empty density bottle weighs 30 gram, that means mass 1 is given 30 gram. Okay, m1 means empty bottle, m2 that is 54 gram, right, when filled with kerosene. And if the volume is 30 milliliter, okay, so first we have to find density. Density equals to mass by volume. So mass will be here 52 minus 30 by V, that is M2 minus M1 by V. This is the formula. Okay, so what is M2 here? 54 minus 30 divided by 30. So here you will be getting 24 by 30. Right? So, or 24 by 30, you can substitute 8 by 10, that is 0.8. 0.8 gram per centi by meter cube. Okay, or centimeter cube here. Okay, 0.8 gram per centimeter cube. So what we have done here, density equals to mass by volume. Mass means M2 minus M1, because this is empty and this is filled kerosene. So we have to subtract. Okay, and volume will be same, because volume of kerosene is the volume of the bottle. So we'll calculate this one, we'll get 8 by 10. We have cancelled it by multiplication table of 3. That is 3 10 and 3 8, that is 8 by 10, that means 0.8 gram per centimeter cube. Now we know 1 gram per centimeter cube equals to 1000 kg per meter cube. Okay, so this is the conversion. So this is the gram per centimeter cube answer. But in kg meter cube answer will be 0.8 into 1000. So this point will remove, 10 will be coming down, 0 got cancelled, that is 800 kg per meter cube. Okay, so this is the second answer and this was the first answer, right. First answer is 0.8 and second answer is 800, that is kg per meter cube and gram per centimeter cube. So the third thing we have to find here, relative density. So relative density formula, density of kerosene in gram per centimeter cube by density of water in gram per centimeter cube, right. So density of kerosene in gram per centimeter cube is how much? 0.8, and density of water in gram per centimeter is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Yes or no? Density of water in CGS unit is 1 gram per centimeter cube. And here, answer we got in gram per centimeter cube, that is 0.8. So 0.8 by 1, that is 0.8 is the relative density. Okay, in the short form we write R dot T. So this is the relative density is 0.8, and gram per centimeter cube is 0.8 gram per centimeter cube, and in kg meter cube, kg per meter cube, we have 800 kg per meter cube. This is the answer. So this is a very important questions of this chapter. You see, an empty density bottle weighs 30.5 2.5 gram. That means when the bottle was empty, this is the mass. When completely filled with water, it is found to be 60.5 gram. When filled with alcohol, it is found to be 53.5 gram. What is the relative density of alcohol? So we have to calculate the relative density of alcohol. First, we will note down what is given in the question. Okay. So an empty relative density bottle weighs this one. That is M1 is 30.5 gram, right? And when it is filled with alcohol, that is 53.5 gram. And when it is filled with water, that is 60.5 gram. Okay. So when it is filled with water, that empty bottle is filled with water, we'll consider M3. When that empty bottle is filled with alcohol, that is a given liquid, that one will consider as M2. And empty bottle mass is M1. Okay. So we need to calculate here relative density. So formula is M2 minus, that is M3 minus M2 minus M1 divided by M3 minus M1. Okay. So this is the formula which you will be using. You will remember this formula, that is M2 minus M1 divided by M3 minus M1. So what is M2 here? M2 is 53.5 minus M1 is 30.5 divided by M3 is 60.5 minus M1 is 30.5. Now when you subtract this one, 53.5 minus 30.5, we will be getting 23. 60.5 minus 30.5, then we will be getting here 30. So when you divide this one, we will get 0.766. okay, so this is the answer. So what is the relative density of alcohol? So relative density equals to 0.766. okay, so first we will have to determine which one is M1, which one is M2 and M3. After getting M1, M2 and M3, we will put in the formula M2 minus M1 by M3 minus M1. So these are the few numericals which we have solved today. So these questions, all you need to write in your exercise book, and also the numericals which you have in your book, which is not similar to these questions, means the question is not same but similar, the type, how I have solved, the formula which I have used, if it is similar, then you will be solving that those questions also in your exercise book. Okay, and in the coming week I will be conducting online test of this chapter, physical quantities and measurements. So be prepared for the exam, and I need 100% response. And make sure students, if you are not serious about the online classes, and when the school gets reopened, this chapter won't be taught again. Okay, so take it seriously and be prepared for your online class and your online test. Okay, thank you.